In this video lecture, I'm going to talk about another important family, which is Oxyuridae. And under this family, two important genera will be discussed. The first one is Oxyuris, and the second one is Enterobious. So important species under these two genera, they are Oxyuris equi, the host is horse and donkey, and another one is Enterobious vermicularis. Previously, it was called Oxyuris vermicularis. The host for this parasite is human and primates. So all these parasites will be located in the large intestine, that is in cecum, colon, and rectum. This parasite is distributed worldwide. And the common name of these parasite is pinworm or seatworm or threadworm. And the disease caused by this parasite, particularly the Oxyuris equi, is Oxyuriasis, pinworm disease, or seatworm disease. But Enterobius vermicularis, the disease name is Enterobiasis. This is important for human and primates. Morphological features of the genus Oxyuris. So these parasites are non-bursate parasite. That is, male parasite doesn't have bursa in their body. What about their size? Male parasite is around 1 centimeter in length, and the female parasite is around 10 to 15 centimeter in length. The color of the female parasite is almost white in color, and the body is curved, and they will have a pointed tail. So due to having this pointed tail, this parasite is also known as pinworm. And the vulva is located anteriorly. For the male parasite, you can see a pointed spicule at the tail end. And another important features, there is no governiculum. But the male parasite will possess two pairs of large and a few small papillae. Another important features of this parasite is the esophagus is double valve shaped. And the larval stage, that is larval stage 4, is around 1 centimeter in length, having a tapering tail, possesses large buccal capsule. And due to having large buccal capsule, they can attach themselves with the intestinal mucosa. Life cycle of Oxyuris species, particularly Oxyuris equi. Oxyuris equi, this parasite is very important for the horse and donkey. And this life cycle is direct life cycle, that is, there is no involvement of intermediate host. And the location of this adult parasite is in large intestine, that is in cecum, colon, and rectum. Infective stage is L3 containing egg, and for the completion of this life cycle, it takes around 5 months. So the male and female parasite will be located in large intestine. After fertilization, the female will move towards the rectum and will crawl out through the anal opening for laying eggs. And this parasite, that is female parasite, will lay eggs in clusters or clumps, and it can be seen as yellowish or white gelatinous streak on the perineal region. And within few hours of egg laying, there will be development of infective stage, that is L3 in eggs. And this infective stage, that is L3 containing egg, will act as the infective stage for the final host. So final host will be infected by having L3 containing egg with contaminated food and water. And after ingestion, this L3 containing egg will be hatched in the small intestine. And afterwards, this L3 will penetrate the intestinal mucosa, and followed by there will be development of L4, which will attach themselves with the mucosa. And finally, in the lumen of the large intestine, there will be male and female parasite. And again, after fertilization, the female will move towards the anal opening, and they will lay eggs in clusters or in clumps in the perineal region. Life cycle of Enterobius vermicularis, which is very similar to the Oxyuris equi. So in this case, the adult parasite will be located in the large intestine, and after fertilization of the male and female parasite, the female parasite will move towards the rectum, and finally the perineal region. They will lay their eggs in clusters, and within few hours, that is 4 to 6 hours, there will be development of L3 within this egg, and final host will be infected by having this egg with food and water. And afterwards, this egg will be hatched out in the small intestine, followed by there will be development of adult parasite. Pathogenesis of Oxyuriasis or Oxyuris equi infestation in horse and donkey. So when the adult parasite located in intestine, there will be no or little pathogenic significance. When L4 stays found in the large intestine, you know, they will have large buccal capsule. As a result, they can attach themselves with the mucus of the large intestine, and that may lead to erosion of the mucosa. As a result, there will be found trypholitis and colitis. So these two conditions can be found in heavy infestation or infection. And enteropruritis can be found due to the perianal irritation by the female parasite while laying eggs. And due to this irritation, there will be rubbing of the perineal region or tail hairs, and that will lead to broken hair or alopecia on the peritoneal region, and this will be look like a red tail appearance. And due to the rubbing of due to intense irritation, the animal will try to get rid of this irritation or pain sensation, and they will try to rub their buttocks of the perineal region with the fixed objects, which will also lead to secondary bacterial infection. And clinical sign includes enteropruritis, which may lead to restlessness, inappetite, dullness. And due to the rubbing of the perineal region or buttocks or tail hairs, there will be alopecia. And as mentioned, it will be look like rat tail appearance. Diagnosis of Oxyuriasis or Oxyuris equi infestation in horse and donkey. So first we should check the clinical history and then clinical sign and findings that I have already mentioned in my previous slide. And the disease can be confirmed by laboratory examination. So fecal examination may not reveal a pinworm infestation, as you know that the female parasite lay eggs in the perineal region as clumps or in clusters that can be visualized as yellowish gelatinous streaks or mass. So the sample could be collected from perineal region using a technique which is called adhesive tape or cell phone tape or Graham techniques. So after examination, you will get the characteristics egg, which is elongated, barrel shaped, and there will be a mucoid plug at the end, and the eggs measures 90 to 42 micrometer. And sometimes when you'll go for gross examination of fecal samples, you may see the adult parasite, which can be voided spontaneously. Enterobiasis. This disease is caused by Enterobious vermicularis, and this parasite is very important for human and primates. So the people of all ages can be infected with this parasite, but children are mostly vulnerable or affected. Majority of the cases, this infection is symptomless, but there will be irritation at the back or in the perineal region. Pathological condition includes pruritis ani. So due to the irritation, there will be some disturb in sleeping of the children. And the adult parasite may migrate to vulva and may cause pruritis bulbi. And this parasite also caused the urinary infection due to the secondary bacterial infection. And the clinical sign of enterobiasis includes nausea, diarrhea, and inappetence. Diagnosis can be made using a technique which is called adhesive tape or cell phone tape or Graham techniques or test. And after examination, there will be found characteristics eggs, that is, the eggs are elongated, slightly flattened on one side,